Alright guys, so some aftermath from last night's work. So I got this separated from my old black one, and remember I thought I had a hairline crack. I did, of course. You can almost see the light through it. I don't know, I can. It's hard to get a good angle, but it's definitely cracked and open right there. And when the badge is on, see, it's so held tight, it's sealed, but you still see a line there. But when I checked it, yeah, it's definitely cracked. This is the old one, of course. This one, I knew this was cracked. So this came out of here. And I fixed the edges of this. I mean, I don't plan to use it, but what I found was the little bumps in the edges were part of the stuff that I had trimmed. See that white crap? I don't remember what brand this is, so I won't say. But I have white showing here, and I had taken the scissors, and there was a thread of the old stuff that I cut under the edge, and that was making a little bump. So I really got it nice now, actually. You can see definitely some white right here. So I'm not going to use this one. I could. It's pretty freaking good. But there's like little dots here and there, little white dots and stuff. I just want to see if I can get a better one with the pro sticker once it arrives. But I'm not going to rip this off yet, because this is a pretty good one. Just in case the other one backfires, I could still come back to this one and leave it sealed. So that's it there. This was off of the new grill. Another specimen for me to work on a paint job for and keep it as a spare, probably. I shouldn't sell them because they're really hard to get. Unless you go buy like a $50 emblem, so I probably need to keep these for my backup. Sorry about that. Oh, these things were a super bitch. Oh my god, I couldn't believe how hard this was. It was ridiculous. It took me over an hour to get these four things off. The glue is so sticky. I had to use all my orange pry bars very carefully so I didn't rip the black tape where this was clipped in here. And I did do it successfully. I didn't damage anything. Whoa. After all this time, I see that I didn't get... There's still some tape that never got removed off of this thing. Now, these things... I couldn't even ship these things. Look how giant they are. And they just get damaged in the shipping. It's not even worth it. Again, if anybody local wants to give it a shot. But it would be a pain to lay out all new tape and stuff. I'll give you that. But I mean, they're not scratched or nothing. They're just fine. I'm just gonna do without them for now and see how that goes. In the big project, you can see here. Oh yeah, I can really see all the pits now. Maybe you can. This is the old grill. The one I bought yesterday is on the car, right? And this one is just shattered with pits everywhere. So I'm gonna practice my sanding techniques on this, and I'm not worried if I destroy it because it is a spare and it's good practice, and I can see if I can finally get some sanding done right. I can feel all this with my hand, so I may start with stronger than a 20, 25 or 2000. I may go 1000 or something and see if I can get it smooth. Then I'll tape it up and paint after that. I just want to see how the sanding goes for now. Of course, sanding it is going to take off all of the shininess off it, right? I was going to tape it first, and I figured I'd rather tape it once it's ready. This actually shows you the chips. This is taking off the glare off of this. Ooh, it's already smooth. Sweet! Oh my god, that worked. What is this? This is a 1000 in my hand. This is bumpy and speckly and rough. This is smooth, it glides. So it may be that easy. And of course, I will do some finer sanding before I just say it's done. Wow, that's all it takes is some thousand to fix all those pits. And of course, it definitely is gonna require some smoothing with better paper. because this is, I'm probably putting all kinds of scratches in it, but that's the whole point of different layers of sandpaper. Alright, now we're going to step up to the 2500. See that for proof? Dip it in my little water here. And we're going to start smoothing this out a little bit, trying to get out some of those scratches we undoubtedly made with the 1500. I like the feel of the wet sand much more. See, it's, oh my God. See what this did dry? This is almost restoring it just with sanding. I may not need to paint it, dude. Oh my God. This is getting out all those specks that I just put in it. Be very careful on the edge. I don't want to like start make the edges look all sloppy, so I'm really getting a flat edge right there. And I clean it with a finger. Oh my God, once I dry that, well actually when it dries it'll probably become cloudy again, you know? But man, that's starting to look really good already without paint. It'd be pretty weird. Of course, I have to use my blower. I'll get out all that dust back there. My air compressor. I'm not using any sanding blocks or anything because I can't mold it like I can mold my hand. It's starting to get sticky, so you want to keep it nice and wet. Oh, the dryer finally finished. All weekend long is laundry time. I actually got to do my own laundry load when the wife's done with her 5 or 6. Yeah, that's about half of it. Man, that's pretty smooth. That's not bad. Yeah, see, when it dries, it won't be shiny like it was, but it's starting to look a lot better. Okay, I'm just about to let it dry and tape it up. I just wanted to show you the final sanding result. And it may not look perfect, but oh, it's 100% different than what it was. I had dots and speckles everywhere. This is a 2500 finish, and I think this is, it feels like glass to the touch, so I'm sure this is smooth enough to do a black gloss paint over. All right, guys, I'm gonna just about to start the painting process. You know how handy these things come in. Oh yeah, get that bead tucked nice and tight. Oh, that's killer. And because this isn't gonna be plasti dip, it shouldn't be too hard to, peel later, I hope. I mean, it doesn't stick. Paint isn't as bad as rubber when you're trying to, like, do that. But this works pretty good. I mean, it's close enough to perfect. It's not absolutely perfect. And I'll go on the inside here. Just tuck that nice and tight. Beautiful. That's a killer paint job. I mean, a tape job. So now I'm gonna start thinking about, I need a big platform to put this on and see if I can start my first coat of paint. One coat of primer. This nozzle doesn't, I know I have those other nozzles to test, but on a project like this, I can't afford to test and find out stuff that doesn't work. So I need to save that nozzle testing for something less important than this. I don't want to overdo the primer, so I'm going to stop right there. It's a little patchy. I've got a few coats on here. I just laid one. I want to be real careful. And it isn't perfect by any means, but it's pretty good.